Hi everyone. In this class, we will discuss about master cylinder, wheel cylinder, and brake fluid. In yesterday's class, we will see what is braking system, and what are the different types of braking system, and what is a mechanical braking system. And what is a hydraulic braking system? In that hydraulic braking system, there are different constructional details. Yesterday, we will see what are the different constructional details of the hydraulic braking system, and what are the different components involved in that hydraulic braking system, and what is the working operation of the hydraulic braking system. These topics we are covered in yesterday's class. Today we will see one of the major component in the hydraulic braking system. It is master cylinder, and next one wheel cylinder, and also brake fluid. These are the major components in the hydraulic brake system. We will see what is master cylinder, and what is the purpose of master cylinder, and what is wheel cylinder, and what is brake fluid. First of all, we can see what is master cylinder. Okay.
Just a second. You can see the hydraulic system of operation, and it is the hydraulic brake system operation. There is a brake pedal depression, and it moves a piston in master cylinder. Fluid under pressure is pushed to slave cylinder. Slave cylinders are located at each wheel. And this hydraulic brake system is obeys the Pascal's law. In that Pascal's law, the pressure is an enclosed system. It is equal and undiminished in all directions. What is the main formula? It is force is equal to pressure into area. That is Pascal's law principle. Force applied to brake linings increase with a larger diameter and wheel cylinder. Okay. So brake pedal depression, that means we can apply the force on the brake pedal. You can see the diagram. We can apply the pressure on the brake pedal. Pressure on the brake pedal. So whenever we will apply the pressure on the brake pedal, a lever is connected to the piston with the help of different joints. The brake pedal pressed automatically, the piston will move. Automatically, the piston is moving. So, in that moving, there is a brake fluid. So, whenever we apply the pressure on the brake pedal, automatically the brake pedal is moving, automatically the piston is moving forward and backward direction. So the piston is used to compress that brake fluid. But whenever the compression process starts on the braking system, automatically the brake fluid is passes through different brake linings. It will reach the front axle wheels and rear axle wheels. Okay, so in that front axle wheels and rear axle wheels, the wheels has wheel cylinders are available. In that wheel cylinders, there is we are arranging drum brakes under disc brake system. So the fluid is passing throughout these drum brakes and disc brakes. The fluid is used to expand those brake shoes or brake pads. Whenever the fluid is passed through disc brakes or drum brakes, it expands the brake pads or brake shoes. These brake pads or brake shoes are attached with the wheel surface to reduce the speed or to stop the vehicle. So it is the overall working of the hydraulic brake system. You can see the what is hydraulic brake fluid and what are the different types of hydraulic brake fluids we are using. Okay, so the hydraulic brake fluid, we can see what are the different types and what is the temperature it is maintained. Glycol based fluids are hygroscopic. Mainly we are using glycol based fluids. It is a very hygroscopic and it absorb water. And it absorb water. And you can see the brake fluid, it has a higher boiling point than water. It has a higher boiling point because of in the compression process, the temperature of the brake fluid is raised. The temperature of the brake fluid is raised. Okay. So the higher boiling point than water, but because this type of brake fluids has very high strength and it absorbs the moisture from vapor under liquid sources. It has a very strong nature. Okay, these are the different properties of this glycol based fluids we are using in the brake fluid and dot specifications. That is, list both dry and wet boiling points. The brake fluid is in dry conditions or the brake fluid is in wet conditions. What is the temperature maintenance? What is the temperature maintenance? You can see the dot specifications. Boiling point of the dry brake fluid is minimum at 205 degrees centigrade. So minimum 205 degrees centigrade and dot 4 230, dot 5.1 260. These are the different standards of the brake fluid. Okay, and wet boiling point minimum 40 degrees centigrade and dot 4 minimum 155 degrees centigrade and dot 5.1 minimum 180 degrees centigrade. These are the different standards of the wet boiling point of the brake fluid. Okay, and you can see what are the different properties of the brake fluid. It does not thicken with changing heat. So does not thicken with changing heat. So high amount of thickness is not occurred in these brake fluids. Only small amount of thickness is available in the brake fluid. So that does not thicken with changing heat and it must not boil. So the boiling is not occurred in this type of brake fluids. It must be compatible with the brake material. It must be compatible with brake material. It must lubricate internal parts. So this brake fluid is also lubricates the internal parts of the braking system. It must not evaporate easily. No evaporation easily. Okay, these are the different properties of the brake fluid. You already known about this hydraulic system operation. These are the different types of hydraulic braking system. One is split hydraulic system and front or rear split hydraulic system, diagonally split system. These are the different types of hydraulic braking system. You can see what is the working of the master cylinder and what are the different components are involved in the master cylinder. Some disc brake calipers are designed to have less drag when brakes are not applied. So some disc brake calipers. So if that disc brakes have a caliper is available. So those calipers are designed to have less drag when brakes are not applied. So we can design that calipers in very less dragging nature. The brakes are not applied in this hydraulic braking system. Why it is not applied? You can see more fluid needed to take up clearance. So in this type of less drag is available on this disc brake calipers. It requires more fluid to work a proper braking system on the automobile vehicle. Okay. So in this type of brake calipers working, it will get more fluid. It will get more amount of fluid. That's why there has such amount of brake fluid is available. It will work. There is no amount of brake fluid is available. The disc brake calipers are not working, then the brakes are not applied. You already seen in some other different videos or some other different images in some other different areas. You already known about this example. So if the vehicle is running, in some other different cases or difficulties, the brake fluid should be leaked. The brake fluid should be leaked. In that condition, the brake fluid all are leaked. There is no amount of brake fluid. We can press the brake pedal. The brakes are not applied. We can press the brake pedal. The brakes are not applied because of there is no brake fluid. The brake fluid is not passed the disc brakes or drum brakes. Those disc brakes and drum brakes not contact with the wheel surfaces, the brakes are not applied. Okay, so that is the main example, and that is the very most thing, the brake fluid used in the hydraulic braking system. Quick take up master cylinder moves larger amount of fluid when pedal first applied.
Whenever the pedal is applied, whenever the pressure is applied on the foot pedal, the large amount of fluid is passed through the brake line systems. And rear of primary piston larger diameter than front. So rear of primary piston, there is a different wheel cylinders in the vehicle. That means the master cylinder is only one in the hydraulic braking system, but the wheel cylinders are different. Every wheel has a one wheel cylinder. Okay, so in that case, rear of primary piston larger diameter than front. So in the front cylinders compared to the rear cylinder, the rear cylinder is very larger diameter, and a larger part of bore allows piston to move large volume of fluid more quickly. So if the cylinder is very larger, the piston moves at a larger volume, the high amount of fluid is passed through that large volume cylinders. Okay, so in that case, the high amount of fluid is passed. Okay, you can see it consists of cast iron cylinder body and a plastic fluid reservoir. It consists of a cast iron cylinder body. So the overall body of the cylinder, it is cast iron.
and the plastic fluid reservoir. The fluid should be stored in a plastic bottle or plastic box, any type of object I am taking to store the fluid, that is called plastic fluid reservoir. Okay. And split design, it is since 1960s. So the in this hydraulic braking system, the master cylinders, we are using split design. This split design is used in since 1960s. Vacuum servo assisted, without the vacuum, much more force is required. So we are using the vacuum in this master cylinder. What is the main reason we are using this vacuum in these cases? Because of we are not applying high amount of forces. We are applying small amount of forces. The brake fluid is passed. Without the vacuum, there is no vacuum. We will give high amount of force. We will give high amount of required force to that fluid passing through the different lines. So it is the different components and those are different properties. You can see what are the constructional details of the master cylinder. Secondary output port, secondary reservoir, primary output port, primary reservoir, push rod, that means piston, sealings and spring. You can see seals, piston return spring. So the piston should return. I'm using piston return spring. These are the different constructional details and different components of the master cylinder. You can see the dual circuit master cylinder. Dual circuit master cylinder. That means we are using two pistons. We are using two pistons uses to pass high amount of fluid and very the brakes are applied very quickly. We are using this dual circuit master cylinders, two front brakes and two rear brakes. So in this master cylinders, one piston, one cylinder is attached in the front brake systems and another piston cylinder is connected with the rear brakes. Okay, so we can apply the force, we can apply the force on the master cylinder. There is a piston one moves, automatically the fluid is passed through the front brakes and also fluid is passed through the rear brakes. Okay, so that is the dual circuit master cylinders. So whenever we apply the force on the piston one, that is two front brakes, whenever the force is applied on the piston two, it is the fluid is passed in the rear brakes. So we have separately applied the pressure on the master cylinder pistons. Okay, so it is the industrial or automobile vehicle braking system master cylinder. It is a quick take up master cylinder, has a bulk in the rear of casting where the bore is larger. You can see the fluid reservoir. It is the fluid reservoir. It is made up of a plastic material. Okay. Next one, what is wheel cylinder? The wheel cylinder consists of a number of components. One wheel cylinder is used for each wheel. The wheel cylinder consists of a number of components. In that one wheel cylinder, there are so many number of components are involved. In one wheel cylinder is used for each wheel. So each wheel have a one cylinder. So the fluid is passed through the master cylinder lines. So in that fluid is stored in the wheel cylinders, and the wheel cylinder fluid is expanded through the disc brakes and drum brake pads. So these disc brake pads and drum brake pads are attached with the wheel surfaces to stop or to reduce the speed. And a pair of pistons operates the shoes, one at each end of the wheel cylinder. One at each end of the wheel cylinder, a pair of piston operates. So in that wheel cylinders have the piston, those pistons are operates the brake shoes. Those pistons are operates the brake shoes. That brake shoes are contact with the wheel surfaces to stop the vehicle. When hydraulic pressure from the master cylinder acts upon the piston cup, the pistons are pushed toward the shoes, forcing them against the drum, and the piston is required to its position by the force of the brake. Shoe return springs when the brakes are not being applied. When the hydraulic pressure from the master cylinder. So whenever we apply the brake pedal, the pressure is passed through that master cylinder's piston, through that fluid is passed through the wheel cylinder. In that, the piston cup, the pistons are pushed towards the shoes. So those fluid is passed through the wheel cylinder, and the wheel cylinder pistons are enlarged with the brake pads or brake shoes, forcing them against the drum, and the piston is returned to its position. So whenever the shoes are moving, the shoes are expanded, automatically the piston gets returned by the help of there is a spring attachment, and the piston is returned to its original position by the force of the brake shoe return springs, and the brakes are not being applied. So just we will apply once the pressure on the brake pedal, automatically the fluid is passable. We can release the brake pedal, we can release the pressure on the brake pedal, automatically the piston should be returned in its original position. So that is the working of the wheel cylinder. You can see what are the components in the wheel cylinder. From master cylinder, in that master cylinder, the fluid is passed through different master cylinder fluid passes lines through this wheel cylinder. There is a piston cup, piston, and compression spring. The compression spring is used to compress the fluid, is passed to enlarge the brake pads or brake shoes. Okay, so that is the working and construction details. And you can see hydraulic system valves and switches. What are the hydraulic system valves and switches? There is a tandem system have a hydraulic safety switches, electric drivers when half of the system fails. It's some master cylinders have a fluid level switch, several designs. You can see switch terminal from the master cylinder, from master cylinder. You can see the components, pistons to rear wheels to front wheels. So there is a switch terminal. Switch terminal, normal pressure. It is tandem system have a hydraulic safety. So these switches are used for the hydraulic safety. It alerts the drivers when half the system fails. So the hydraulic system is fails. The hydraulic braking system is fails. The switches are used to give the signal to the driver. So alerts the driver when half the system fails. Some master cylinders have a fluid level switch. Some other master cylinders, the brake fluid level switches are available. So those are several designs. Next, hydraulic control valves. It is meeting valve, proportioning valves, and newer cars. You can see metering valve used on front disc brakes. When car has rear drum brakes, it prevent front brakes applying until rear shoes overcome the spring pressure and contact the drums. It is unnecessary with the four-wheel disc brakes. So this metering valve is used on the front disc brakes. These metering valves are used in the front disc brakes of the vehicle. When car has a rear drum brakes, if the car is taking, the metering valve is placed in the rear drum brakes. It prevents front brakes applying until rear shoes overcome spring pressure and contact the drum. We can apply the front brakes. We can apply the front brakes applying until rear shoes, that means rear brake shoes, are also overcome the spring pressure and contact with the drum. Contact with the drum. Simply, what I am told is we can apply the front brakes automatically. The brake is applied on the rear brakes also. It is unnecessary with the four-wheel disc brakes. It is unnecessary four-wheel disc brakes. The brakes is not applied individually on these vehicles of these hydraulic control valves. And propositioning valves, it prevents the rear wheels from locking during hard stop. We required hard stop. So these hydraulic control valves of the propositioning valves are used to prevent the rear wheels from locking during hard stop. Next, newer cars, it is equipped with a anti-lock brakes. Pressure control valves and switches. All modern brake hydraulic systems contain pressure control valves. In modern vehicles or some other different vehicles, we are using pressure control valves. These systems also contain brake switches which operate dashboard mounted warning lights or illuminate. The rear brake lights, pressure control valves affect the hydraulic pressure delivered to the wheel units. It can make brake action more efficient. Brake switches are used to illuminate warning lights on the dashboard, alerting the driver to the presence of a brake problem. These are the different uses we are using pressure control valves and switches in the hydraulic braking system. Next, metering valve. The front brake pads are very close to the rotor and are the not held in the retracted position. When the brakes are first applied, hydraulic pressure moves the front disc pads into contact with the rotor almost immediately. Okay. However, the rear brake shoes are held in the retracted position by retaining the springs and must overcome spring pressure to move up the shoes into contact with the drum. So this is the use of metering valve in the hydraulic brake system. It is the metering valve. There is a pressure from master cylinder to front disc brake system. Fluid pressure builds until valve opens to front disc brake valves. You can see the operation. There is a pressure is applied on the cylinder. The piston should be moving. Pressure from the master cylinder. Okay, so to front disc brake is applied, fluid pressure builds until valve opens. The valve is open whenever the pressure is applied. So to front disc brake, the fluid is the pressure is passes through the front disc brakes and to front disc brake. You can see the to front disc brake of the system. It is the master cylinder and valves. Whenever the pressure is applied, the valves are open. Metering check valve assembly. Okay, so these are the different valves in the master cylinders and wheel cylinders of the hydraulic brake system. Okay, next, steel brake lines. Whenever possible, the hydraulic system uses rigid steel brake lines. So the steel brake lines is also used in the hydraulic braking system. Sometimes it is called tubing or to transmit hydraulic pressure. Next, steel lines are resistant to collision damage and vibration, can stand to high brake system pressures and are relatively inexpensive. For added safety, the steel is used in the lines is double wall thickness, welded steel made from the copper coated sheet steel. Okay. So these are the different materials are also used in the hydraulic braking system. So it is overall about the hydraulic braking system. In next class, we will see the another braking system in the another braking systems. So thank you guys.